Most people in America have a particular way in which they wear their hair. For men who have lost their hair on their head, or they have it thinning, they will often shave their head or burr their hair so that it's less visible to other people. Male pattern baldness is something that is inherited, and it is generally considered genetic, unless I've missed some new scientific studies, but openly when a man loses hair up top, he often has hair all over his body or grows a beard. I once had hair all over my body, except I've woken several times without a consistency of time. Now, what I'm saying to you is that there are human traffickers that can play your food and ruin your life. And they feel so good in their mood about what they've been able to accomplish that they never stop. They continue to abuse over and over again. But a physically small-statured person might try to walk into someone's house, walk into someone's tent, and abuse them. As a man who has been perversely attacked for his pagan beliefs and my beard for my priesthood, literally cut and trimmed several times in the night without my lawful consent, I am saying to the perpetrator of crime, you should be in federal jail for the violation of my privacy rights, my personal space, and the fact that you've committed a sexual offense called usually mutilation or molestation. The line can be drawn in the sand federally, not locally, not personally, not in some opinion. I don't know you, because if I know you, I'd be sitting before you in some sort of a barber shop. One fella did shave my head for me, and it really helped me. But I said, do not touch my priest beard. Now, whether he continued to play at me with his family, his friends, his black neighborhood, I cannot say. I do know that he picked up my hair, which he didn't need to do for me that day. What did he do with my hair? Why did he take it from me? Is it in some sort of voodoo thing? I don't know, but hey, I throw it out there. As just a buyer beware. But he was very kind. He was very helpful. He did it for free. But I had also spent some time advising him a little about his business. Now, people who help me, I appreciate, but it doesn't give you the right to do one thing to me. The liars of Satan, the Christians who have lied to themselves, who lie internally all the time, are saying, I gave you money, which is financial abuse in that way, so I'm going to do this to you, or I'm going to take this for me. That might work in foreign countries, and I had an Indian boy once buy me a couple Gatorades and then buy me a sandwich, and it might have cost him a total of $10 total at most. And when I came out to my pack, do you know what was missing? One of my little marvelous military-oriented, flame-decorated, kind of Harley Davidson's rubberized pouches that I carried my beverages in. What was in there was markers and 3x5 cards for me. It was completely gone off my pack. Now that shows the mentality of an Indian boy who couldn't wait for me to pick up my lunch and just left me there. Now, is it logical to think he took it? I think it is. Could someone else have stolen it? Absolutely. But why did they do that when we have laws in America that say, thou shalt not steal? You see, college kids think it's a prank. It's not a prank. It's a federal offense.